Hey guys, this video is going to go over part of the endomembrane system. Lesson that we were doing today that I really realized a little bit too late that it was tough on the Jamboard. I'm also going to repost the doc that I did with you guys because I added some notes to that as well for the other class. So just check all that stuff out on Classroom when it gets posted. I'll probably put the doc along with this video in the same post. So you probably should have seen the doc by the time you watch this. Anywho, getting started. The drawing that we were setting up, we had the nucleus in the corner. And then we had, I'm actually gonna make all the cell membranes red. So remember, the nucleus has our chromatin in it. It's gonna be DNA wrapped around proteins. And that's in the nucleus. But the nucleus also has the nuclear membrane, right? The sometimes called the nuclear envelope. Same thing. That's going to be a membrane. Then remember, the ER is a membrane, right? I'm gonna give it a little bit of a three-dimensional look there, but it's not going to be perfect. We have, of course, the outer surface of the cell is a membrane. You can see out there, and the Golgi has more of like a sac-like structure than the ER, but it's also a folded membrane as well. So there's the Golgi. The lysosome is a membrane. I mean, really, when it comes down to it, what is not a membrane in the cell? Really, the only thing that's not either membrane bound or a membrane itself are ribosomes. Now, when I say that proteins make most cell structures, I'm still right about that, because proteins, of course, make up most of the internal structures of mitochondria, chloroplasts, and all the enzymes and transport proteins and the cytoskeleton and all this stuff within cells. There's a lot of structural proteins, of course, but fibers and muscle cells. But there's also a lot of structural lipids, and we see that with the cell membranes and the internal membranes here. So endomembrane system really means the internal membrane system. And here's what's going to happen. Here are some free ribosomes. Right, and here are some attached ribosomes. So if I were to, I'm gonna make this ribosome a little bit bigger just to kind of make my point here. So if we had some mRNA coming out of the nucleus, I'm gonna do this first. Here's the mRNA. It's floating through the cytoplasm. And it's going to come out to a ribosome, and it's going to bind with that ribosome and move through it, and a protein gets made. As the ribosome is reading that code, if the code seems to be for a enzyme or a protein to be active in the nucleus, that ribosome is going to stay free, and it's going to make the protein. I'll make my proteins. I got all the kinds of colors here. I'll make my proteins purple, right? And so it's going to make the protein. There it is. I'm not suggesting the protein is going to be bigger than the ribosome, but there's a little protein that got made, and it's going to float freely. That's it. And we're done. We made the protein, and the protein is active where it's supposed to be. Now, the nucleus is kind of a specific destination, but this is what I was saying to you in class. I do get kind of confused about this one detail of this, and I've never been able to kind of clear it up with myself. That seems like a specific destination. It seems like it should be shipped by the endomembrane system, but apparently it's not. So maybe it just drifts into the nucleus somehow. Okay, so that would be the simplest version of the story, an end of story. Okay, however, I shouldn't have just erased that, honestly. If that mRNA comes out to the ribosome, binds with the ribosome, and the ribosome is reading code for a protein that's going to end up, remember our destinations, end up in a lysosome, in the membrane of the cell, or shipped out of the cell, that needs to be modified and shipped by the endomembrane system. So in that case, if that mRNA kind of comes out here and that code becomes apparent, the ribosome will move down to the ER, blink, and attach to the ER. And now that protein, I gotta do it purple. Now that protein is gonna get made, and it's going to be now on the ER. and it's going to be able to move around the ER, maybe moving into an internal space within the ER. Remember, the internal spaces of the ER are called the lumen. And that's a general word in biology for the internal space of anything. We could talk about food moving through the lumen of your small intestines. We could even describe the internal space of an enclosed sac structure like the lysosome as the lumen, I believe. So lumen just means internal space. You might want to note that down because that does come up a couple times. And what is the ER doing for it? The thing you really got to know is that it's modifying the protein, right? ER modifies the protein. And what does that mean? It usually means attaching chemical groups to it, attaching carb chains, attaching a lipid, attaching a phosphate. We don't need to go into excruciating detail right now, but we're going to add smaller molecules to that protein to tell the cell this needs to go into a vesicle and out to the Golgi apparatus. That's where it's going. So let's say this thing is modified. And then here's the cool thing about vesicles. It doesn't have to move all around the ER. I'm just saying it's going to be kind of physically moved on the surface or in an internal space, lumen of the ER. And then vesicles are temporary transport sacs. And the ER is made of a membrane as well. So we can make a vesicle out of the ER. So we can sort of pinch together almost like this, if you can see this. I can't really zoom in very well on my video here, sorry. Right? We could almost get a vesicle sort of pinched off of the ER. This little red vesicle right here, that used to be part of the ER, but now it's a vesicle and it's carrying the protein out here. So here's the path of the protein. And when it gets here, that vesicle can sort of fuse with the Golgi. And remember, the vesicle is carrying our protein. And as it fuses with the Golgi, that membrane vesicle, it becomes kind of part of the Golgi itself, like this. And now, where is our protein? The protein is now in the Golgi, right? What is the Golgi doing? It tags the protein for shipment. As the doc now says, this is going to involve glycosylation or adding a carb group if it's being shipped out of the cell, and it's going to involve phosphorylation or adding a phosphate if it is going to be active within the cell as an enzyme. But it's going to basically, remember the Golgi, the analogy there is like a post office. This protein could eventually be shipped again by a vesicle, but it could be shipped, I'll draw the vesicle again. And that vesicle can be pinched off of the Golgi like we saw here. Right, so that could be put into, I'm gonna draw the vesicle kind of releasing it. It could be into the membrane, and now it's been put in the membrane. It could be shipped out of the cell, right? Exocytosis. Or we could say the protein has been secreted. I know you can barely see that coming off the edge of the cell there. Or it might ship it again in a vesicle. It's always transport in a vesicle. And that word I keep saying is this vesicle, V-E-S-I-C-L-E. Temporary transport sac. Sorry, I'm being annoying, I know, but I just wanted to make sure that was clear. Or it could be going into the lysosome, right? And where it might be active in there as a hydrolytic enzyme. So this would be a membrane protein. This would be a hormone. This would be a hydrolytic or digestive enzyme in a lysosome. And remember that the key feature here throughout this whole story is the membranes, right? Because the membranes allow cells to compartmentalize reactions, right? They create little internal spaces that are separate from external spaces. Okay, and that should, one more thing. I'm gonna zoom in there. My camera's gonna fall over as I shake the table. All right, let's pretend this is a completely different picture. Close-up view. Whoa, there goes the camera. Close-up view of endocytosis and exocytosis. Some of you I know remember this. Oh, come on, camera, stay up. Okay. Here's a cell. Here is the vesicle transport. Actually, you know what? Sorry, let me do this a different way. This is step one. Here's the protein in the vesicle. Here's step two. Camera. Shoot, sorry guys. Trying to do my best here. My tripod is not excellent. Step two, the vesicle fuses with the membrane. Step three, the protein is released to the outside of the cell. This process going this way would be exocytosis, right? Exiting the cell. If we were to reverse the arrows and do step one, two, three this way, that would be cytosis. Okay, so that wraps that up. Those are important words. And there's endocytosis going that way. Sorry you missed that. And that'll do it for this video. Later.